What's going on, guys? I'm Chris, and welcome back to another video. Today, I'm going to be giving you my review of Amazon Prime Video's Encounter, the latest film starring Riz Ahmed. Two brothers embark on a journey with their father, who is trying to protect them from an alien threat. So before I give you guys my thoughts on this movie, make sure to hit that like button, comment your thoughts or expectations down below if you have not yet watched it, and make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future reviews, rankings, all that good stuff. So with a name like Encounter and a poster that looks very sci-fi, I went into this movie expecting the next big science fiction movie. And I'm here to say, that's not really the case. And to be honest, this feels like three different movies in one. Like I mentioned, it was marketed as a sci-fi movie, and early on in this film, it's very sci-fi heavy. Like, the first act of this movie really set it up to be this sci-fi film, as the premise alone involves an alien species invading humans, and it's very low-key though, so it was a really interesting, intriguing concept, as it was like, oh my gosh, there's an alien invasion happening, and humanity doesn't even know what's going on. However, it quickly evolves into a variety of genres. So much so to the point where I didn't know if the movie wanted to be a family drama or a man-on-the-run thriller, or at times a comedy. And this really upset me because, again, the mood was set at the very beginning of this movie for a sci-fi film. And like the description says, this movie centers on Riz Ahmed, who's a father, and his relationship with his two sons. So that needs to be a very powerful and emotional relationship that audiences can connect with, and that was not the case for me. Based on Riz Ahmed's character's history, it makes sense as to why there's kind of a struggle for this relationship to work, but it was a really sporadic relationship. I'm talking like they would be driving in the car one scene, laughing, cracking jokes, just having a great father-son time. And then a minute later, he'd be screaming at them, scaring them, and then apologizing. It was just all over the place. And if you see the movie, you may understand why his character acts this way. But all that being said, it made it really hard to actually empathize with Riz Ahmed and understand where he's coming from and really feel the emotions that his character is going through. And I feel like that relationship between father and the two sons kind of summarizes this entire movie in the way that it felt. It was wildly inconsistent. Like, I kid you not, there were really jarring tonal shifts where a scene would go from being very lighthearted and filled with levity to extremely dark pretty quickly. Early on in this movie, certain key details are withheld from the audience, and this leads to moments of confusion and a lot of questioning as to what is going on in society. I feel like most people who watch this movie are gonna have the same questions I was having. I'm not gonna pose those questions just out of the sake of spoilers. Hell, I think one of the kids even makes a valid point about it. And when those key details actually are revealed, I feel like the movie gets kind of soured by it. Like, I feel like the movie thought it was a lot more clever than it actually was, so when those clever attempts failed, really kind of took me out of the movie. Now, Riz Ahmed is an actor who I have an immense amount of respect for. I think he is one of the better young talents working today. He just came off an Oscar nomination. However, in this movie, it just didn't really work for me. His character is doing this southern drawl, which really just kind of removed me from the movie. Like, his accent honestly got distracting to me. And I'll say he's the only performance that kind of even stands out, because everyone else is just extremely average. It feels like any other generic performance you would see in like a consistent network television show where like there's a detective crew or there's just a family or something. Like, nothing stands out amongst the crowd. They're not really bad performances. They're just kind of there. I think the two kids do the best they can. The younger kid obviously probably doesn't have a ton of acting experience. I thought he actually did a better job than the older son, who at times you could tell he didn't really have a lot of acting experience, but at the same time, he didn't do terrible. So I can safely say that I was intrigued by the opening premise of this movie. It kind of hooked me in, and I was ready to go on this sci-fi adventure. It just really veered from its original path, so much so that it ended up being a little bit of a bummer. The film goes on a really scattered journey that's all over the place from a genre perspective and a tonal perspective, and it really just made it hard to get on board with everything that happened. Certain scenes definitely bear entertainment value, but the deeper themes about PTSD and father-son relationships just really missed the mark for me. I'm gonna give Encounter 2 out of 5 stars. It's by no means the worst movie of the year, but it's definitely not the best. I can't recommend that you guys watch this one. It's just all over the place. And if you have seen the movie, let me know in the comments down below what you thought, as well as what your thoughts were on some of those reveals that were made. But that's gonna do it for my thoughts on Amazon Prime Video's Encounter. Definitely hit that like button, comment your thoughts on the movie down below, as well as your expectations if you have not seen it yet. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any future reviews like this one. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.